Okay, this should be working there. Yep. So, Happy New Year, and it's great to be with you again. Every time I come to this church, I love you a little bit more. As Christian said, we're currently discerning whether I might be doing some more ministerial work with you. So part of today is about getting to know each other a bit more. But only part. Because whatever I am, I'm not your saviour,
your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship His holy. Your holy name. You're rich in love and you're slow to anger. Your name is great and your heart is kind. For all your goodness I will keep on saying. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. So bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship His holy name. Time has come, still my soul will sing your praise unending. 10,000 years and then His holy name. Sing like never before. Oh my soul, I worship your holy name. Come on, bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul, worship His holy name. Your holy name, Lord, I worship your holy name. Sing like never.
Gifts we give in other ways for your glory. Amen. changes too. We have floods in parts of this country. The earthquake in Japan.
Soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not run. peacemakers, for they will be called sons of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted because of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people insult you, persecute you, and falsely say all kinds of evil against you because of me.
We're told to be glad about it. those who speak the truth of God will face difficulties because there are an awful lot of people who don't want to hear it and don't want it said. So if God is not raising us up to this life of luxury that we see on TV, and he is not raising us up out of trouble, then what does he raise us up to? Firstly, he is raising us up to eternity. The troubles of this world will not last forever. Whatever difficulties you face, whether financial, health-related, or in your relationships, whatever struggles and injustices, you will not face them into eternity. Through the sacrifice Jesus made on the cross, he is bringing about a new heaven and earth. And in this new heaven and earth, there will be no more tears or pain. Now, I know that the book of Revelation is a difficult read, but in the last two chapters, this future is described, and it is a beautiful vision of hope. And I know personally that in my toughest times, some of those verses have been so important to me, about no more tears, no more pain, no more suffering. I'm going to say more about other ways that Jesus raises us up, but for those days when you are in pain, and when it feels like that pain is without end, hold on to that hope. This time of hardship and brokenness will be healed, and the time after that will be so long that it will make this time seem like the smallest dot on our timeline. Now, secondly, Jesus is raising us up as his children. He's raising us, he is growing us to be more like him. And often he uses our troubles to do that. He raises us through our troubles. Now, I can't talk for you, but I know that I grow more in adversity. I have become less afraid by facing my fears. I have become more empathetic and loving through my own experiences of pain and suffering. And I know that I'm not the only one that feels like that. There was this pop song a number of years ago by Faith Evans. It always gets stuck in my head, and it sums it up well. It goes, "If I had to do it all again, I wouldn't take away the rain, because I know it made me who I am." And when we look at the Beatitudes like that, they are not so surprising. I imagine that you are like me. When I read the first line of those blessings, I don't want to be like that. I don't want to be in Paul, or in mourning, or any of that. But if that is the way to get the second part, then yes, I do. Taking us out of those troubles before we could grow would not be raising us up. It would be stunting our growth and keeping us down. God raises us through our troubles. And he doesn't just raise us up as individuals, because it also enables us to empathize, comfort, and share God with those who are experiencing trouble. If we have never experienced God in the midst of trouble, how can we speak of God to those in trouble? If we have never had our own troubles, how can we comfort others in theirs? We have to share in the troubles and brokenness of this world in order to be part of God's mission to save. He raises our head above the surface of our troubles so that we are not overwhelmed by them. He gives us the peace that surpasses understanding, peace in our hearts when everything around us seems to be at war. He gives us joy even when the world cannot see anything that would make us joyful. He enables us to forgive and heal through that forgiveness, despite clear injustice against us. And to let go of those traumas that hold us down. He enables us to rise above the darkness and despair that we see in the world around us. And there's a hymn that contains the line, "Turn your eyes upon Jesus, look full in his wonderful face, and the things of earth will grow strange and dim in the light of his glory and grace." And that, on the whole, has been my experience. During the hardest time in my life, I remember him being the roof over my head, the walls holding me up, and the ground under my feet. He has carried me time and time again, and I know many other people would say the same. You know, there's that very famous poem, Footsteps poem, just about that. Sometimes our paths in life make us walk on broken glass, but he lifts us up so that it doesn't cut our feet. That, in my experience, is how he raises us up. And one final thing. Through much of this sermon, I have suggested that Jesus doesn't always raise us up out of our troubles. But I want to stress now that he sometimes does. In fact, he often does. Have any of you heard of the Eternal Wall of Answered Prayer? Anyone heard of that? No. It's a massive monument that they're building in the Midlands, just outside Birmingham. It's just, you're going to be able to see it from the motorways, it's going to be huge. It's made out of 1 million bricks. And each brick is linked to an answered prayer, so they're getting people to send in stories of answered prayer to link to the bricks. So if you go on their website, you can read some of these stories of answered prayer. They're wonderful. It's the Eternal Wall of Answered Prayer. Or you can just talk to each other about times that your prayers have been answered. Because I know there's going to be no shortage from the mundane to the miraculous. It might be I prayed for a parking space and I got one. It might be, you know, it might be that you prayed for healing and you got it. There are so many stories out there if we as Christians just talk to each other about them. And the stories of Jesus are full of healings and other miracles. God answers prayer. And God makes good things happen in people's lives. Now, they won't happen if God has a plan to grow us through our troubles. But he won't leave us in trouble for no reason. Often, the only thing we need to do in trouble is to ask God to get us out. God gives us choice in all situations. He doesn't force his will upon us. So sometimes we need to ask him to act. Sometimes we need to ask him before we walk into the trouble in the first place. Asking God for help is also an act of humility. It's important for us to realise that in many situations we can't raise ourselves up. We certainly can't raise ourselves up into eternity. some rich areas versus poor areas, you see more churches in the poor areas than you would in the rich areas.
You see that.
Recognizing a need for God is important. So sometimes us asking is all he is waiting for to raise us up out of our troubles. So what is God raising us up to? He's raising us up to him. He loves us and he is raising us up to him. To be with him in eternity, to be like him. One who is above the troubles of this world, yet still cares deeply about them. He is raising us up to love. I'm going to give us a moment of just quiet prayer, and then I'm going to ask questions to come up.
Ooh. to more than I can be. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. Raise me up to more.
Covenant simple in sinful people who know forgiveness. The weary who are refreshed, the hungry who are nourished, the captives who are set free, and the oppressed who experience liberation. Thank you that you chose to make us a part of your story. Thank you for Jesus Christ, who revealed your love in his death and resurrection, and who continues to share his life with us through bread and wine. Thank you for sending the Holy Spirit, who sustains us in our walk together, helping us to watch over each other, to pray for one another, and to work together for justice and truth. As we eat this bread and drink from the cup, signs of hospitality and grace, may we be empowered to serve boldly wherever you may call. Accept these prayers and our heartfelt thanksgiving in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Among friends gathered around the table, Jesus took bread, broke it, and said, "This is my body, which is for you." We're going to pass around the bread as you receive it. Please eat it as you receive it.
Thank you.
sweet the sound
exciting.
That saves.